Okay, this chapter is titled The Algebra of Rational Numbers. So now we get into some algebra. Okay, very basic stuff. We're gonna deal with x terms. Okay, in the next chapter we'll be solving equations for an unknown variable. Most of the time we'll call it x. Okay, but before we do that, we need to look at operations on these algebraic expressions. Okay, it's gonna work a lot like the operations on the integers and the operations on fractions that we've done before. Okay, so how do I deal with this? 3x minus 4x, I get two x terms. What we're gonna do here is just do the operation on the coefficients, what's called the coefficients. These are the numbers that are multiplied by the x term. This means 3 times x, 4 times x, okay? So an x term minus an x term is still an x term, all right? So 3x minus 4x is simply, I go 3 minus 4, which is negative 1, x. Okay, so if I can do operations on integers and fractions, I can do operations on these algebraic expressions, that is, with addition and subtraction. Okay, we'll talk about division and multiplication a little bit later. Just one note, negative 1x is the same thing as negative x. Most of the time you'll see it written like this. We can use this to help us keep track of what negative x means. It means negative 1 times x, because we'll have to use these coefficients. Okay? All right, example 2. Fractions. So if you follow what I said in this first example, all we're going to do is the operation where we're adding and subtracting these algebraic terms, okay, then all I have to do is perform that operation on these numbers in front of them, okay, or the coefficients. So if I want to do 1/8x minus 4/3 x, basically I just have to go 1/8 minus 4/3 and tack an x on, right? That's the operation here. So what do I need to do? I got fractions and I'm subtracting, I need a least common denominator. Right, so we did that in the last section. 8 and 3, what's the least common denominator? I started looking at the multiples of 8. 8 times 1 is 8. 3 doesn't go into that. 8 times 2 is 16. 3 won't go into that. And then 8 times 3 is going to work here, right? Because 8 times 3 is 24. 3, of course, will go into that. So I realize that LCD is 24. Okay, notice the difference here is that these are x terms. Right, so the x is still attached to those terms. So how did I get from 8 to 24? I multiplied by 3, so I gotta multiply that by 3. So 1/8 times x is the same thing as 3/24 times x. Right? 4/3 x, multiply that by 3. Gotta multiply that. I'm sorry, I multiply this by 8, 3 times 8 to get 24. Multiply that by 8 to get 32. Okay? And then I follow my rules from there. 3 over 24x minus 32 over 24x is still going to be an x term. I just do 3 minus 32, which is negative 29. Okay, so we can add and subtract fractions, and we can add and subtract x terms with fraction coefficients. All right, same thing. All right, so first two examples had these algebraic terms with the x, a little new to us. Example 3 has kind of a combination of the two, and we'll be dealing with these when we solve equations. Numbers, okay, or constant terms, whether they be integers or fractions, and these algebraic terms, or x terms, alright? So what I do, we have to consider what's called like terms here. Just like we did in here, we can bring these two x terms together, but I cannot subtract 5 from 4x, because they're not like terms. Okay, like terms are identified by their variable and the power. In this case, our power is only 1. We'll get into higher powers later. Okay, so for this chapter, we have to identify like terms basically by deciding which terms are x terms and which terms are constant terms. Okay, so in other words, I can bring these two guys together, 4x and 6x, and I can bring these two guys together, negative 5 and negative 3. And then I'll be stuck. I'll be done at that point. I'm an x term and a number term. Can't bring those together, they're not like, okay? Here's what I like to do. I like to box my two x terms, all right? So I can kind of reduce my problem a little bit. I can ignore these two number terms, the two constants, and go 4x minus 6x. That's negative 2x. And I can say negative 5 minus 3 if you want. We can circle those. Negative 5 minus 3, we talked about that in the last chapter. Two negatives, add negative 8. keep the negative sign, right? 5 and 3 is 8, and keep the negative sign, right? That's not multiplication, right? We're adding two negative numbers, we're taking 3 away from negative 5, same thing. Either way, I get negative 8, okay? So, example 1, 2x terms, example 2, 2x terms, fraction coefficients. Example 3, this is really what we're going to be doing more with. We're dealing with x terms and constant terms. Okay, so it's important to realize what I can bring together and what I can't. I can bring the two x terms together. I can bring the two numbers together. But right here, I can't go any further. Don't try and say negative 2x minus 8 is negative 10x, because that's not correct. Not like terms, so I got to stop. All right?